Grimfangs, welcome to Delta Force 2. Now, saying all those long names all this while sort of makes you feel like something's been missing here, but no, that's just the name of the title, Delta Force 2. Short and sweet. Anyway, so yeah, this is a Milsim shooter, for those of you who don't know. I do remember fondly playing the demo of this game as a child, although I couldn't make head or tails of it. But yeah, I'm hoping that I would enjoy the full game more now that I've grown up to be an adult. Yeah, I know my parents were pretty irresponsible with the games that they let me play, but yeah, that made me who I am, so I don't really have any regrets about that. Anyhow, I have played this game before, as in I already recorded 3 levels of it, and while looking for a problem to a solution to a certain problem, I figured out that I can actually upscale it to 1080p and solve that problem to an extent, of course. So that's why we're here trying to, well, that's why I'm here again, re-recording these levels. So basically, this game, before it started, is divided into 2 campaigns, called Operation Common Resolve and Operation Global Enforcement, and there are quick missions that are independent of each other and the campaigns. So I'm gonna start with Operation, you know, Common Resolve first, and then go to Global Enforcement, and then I'm gonna cover all of the individual quick missions. So with that being said, let us go ahead and start off with Operation Common Resolve. Bioterrorism is no longer a what-if-it-happens exercise. It is now an immediate possibility. 48 hours ago, unknown forces raided a top-secret P4 laboratory in the Antarctic. Your team will immediately investigate and assess the situation. That's as brief a intro as it gets. You know, not exactly an intro, more like a briefing, sort of. Not exactly briefing either. Anyway, let's, the first mission here is actually Operation Cold Storage. Have deadly viruses fallen into the terrorist hands? Secure Objective Blizzard and determine the extent of the damage. Now, one of the good things that I like about this game is how they have added voice lines to the briefing, so I don't need to read it out for myself.
48 hours ago, contact was lost with a top secret research facility located in the Antarctic. Codenamed Blizzard, the base is used to research cures for viral agents created and used by groups not adhering to biological warfare treaties. The cold climate acts as a barrier against accidental contamination. A recent overflight by a KH-12 reconnaissance satellite shows extensive damage to the facility. You are ordered to secure the lab and assess the situation. Alpha and Bravo teams will be inserted southwest of the lab. From there, all squads will move in and secure Blizzard. Once the facility is retaken, notify King 6 and stand by for further orders.
And that's it. I mean, I really like the fact that they have this, you know, briefing readout section. I mean, I can read it out as well if I want to, but I just like to let the lady do it. Shotgun sucks. I'm gonna switch over to the grenade. And yeah, extra ammo, Kevlar vest, everything seems fine. We also have 2 types of grenade. One is a delayed fragmentation, which is like a real life grenade. It explodes after a delay, it has a fuse, and this is an impact grenade. Now, I don't know whether this is realistic or just fiction, but yeah, you toss it and as soon as it lands, it explodes. I would think that's pretty...
All King elements, moving to secure the base. Watch for civilians.
That's pretty... risky. Now, I know exactly how this mission goes, Dead Scientist here. So basically, we have to go inside the base and secure a few hostages. Just a moment. Obviously. Sorry about that. I mean, it's most likely not going to make the cut anyway, so yeah. So, one of the things that I noticed is the fact that...
Bravo, this is Alpha 1. Base is alert. I say again, base is alert.
No shit, genius. Although I probably should not be swearing in this game. Like on YouTube, at least. There should be another guy here. Where is this guy? Yeah, right here. Oh yeah, right. I forgot. No? Yeah, semi-auto. Let me switch it to semi-auto mode. Conserve bullets. Not that I particularly need to, but it's better to do so. There's gonna be one guy up there as well. We need to be careful.
Bravo, this is Alpha 1. Watch for shooters in the towers.
Taken care of. Now, this game, as it turns out, it relies entirely on your CPU for its rendering. So, whenever events like these occur that you can see, I'm not gonna go in there yet. So, there's a guy inside this building here that's shooting at me, I suppose. So, I'm not gonna go inside this building yet. What I'm gonna do is, I'm just gonna hang out here and take care of the guards around the perimeter.
Moving in.
Roger that. You are weapons free, clear to engage.
Roger. Although I'm not gonna engage just yet, I hope none of the other guards get a drop on me. I'm trying to maintain as much cover as possible. This should be, yeah, there's a guy right there. Should be another guy somewhere around here. There, but there is supposed to be another guy somewhere around here. Is that? No, that is Alpha 2. Pretty sure that's our friends getting their asses handed to them. Should be another guy somewhere over there. Right inside this here section. We just need to be a little cautious in our approach, especially. Now, that's the thing about this game, that you need to be cautious. And the primary reason...
I don't want to die!
Why you need to be cautious is because, well... Oh no, those guys saw me. Somebody hit me, I don't know whether that was that guy or not. Oh no, I'm falling down. I'm falling down, help! I don't want to fall all the way down, come on, no. Safe. For now, at least. There still are other enemies over on that side. See, the thing is, I don't exactly want to get into a quick draw contest. Because if I do that, the AI will always win invariably. So I want to make sure that that is a scientist, that those are terrorists. The game lags again. Although it probably should not have been lagging, but it does lag again. And I think we are clear on this section. We just need to be a little careful of this. Supposed to be another guy in there that we need to take care of. I'm just gonna quickly move over to that area and try to take care of that guy. That is a scientist. There was supposed to be somebody over here. Typically is somebody in here, but, well, can't see them as of right now. I'm just gonna let them be then. Now, most of these areas have very poor level design, and I say that because, well, it is especially difficult to get into these sections and essentially clear the enemy the area of enemy hostiles. It always usually boils down to either a quick draw contest, which the AI typically wins, or you have areas like this, flats, like flat grounds with minimal cover, where you can't really engage the enemies as effectively. I'm gonna go upstairs first to get a better vantage point on a potential target over there that these guys just usually typically ignore. Seems like they have taken care of the target for today. Now, there are a few other targets that we need to be a little cautious about. For one, there's a target inside of this room here. And I'm not going to engage him directly, I'm just gonna use my grenade launcher. That guy's dead. Like, if he was not dead, then it would be sad. I don't know whether I killed any civilians in that, doing that little maneuver or not. There's another guy here. As soon as we come back into the light, this guy's gonna hook back here. Switching back to semi-auto. Now, we can go up there, but it's more of an exercise in futility. Oh yeah, but they can shoot through walls as well. So, be careful when you're engaging hostiles. I assume everybody's dead here? Good. Even though I killed most of them, to be honest, but still. And I think there's one final enemy somewhere over there, as far as the map shows. Now, we can just use the grenade launcher. Voila.
Oh. In the tower! Now, shooting in the tower! Base secure, but it looks like they've moved some of the hostages.
Roger, Alpha. King 6 to all elements. Hostages have been removed. Proceed to extraction point.
Roger, King 6. Now, here's the thing. There are some improvements as compared to the previous title. Going into buildings or near buildings no longer hangs the game. So that's like a huge improvement, especially considering the fact that this game is entirely set inside buildings for the most part. Now, point number two, like, you have to go near buildings a lot. Point number two, a point which I don't like particularly, like, there is no debriefing. It's just move on to the next mission, which sort of breaks the continuity a little. But anyway, that was it for today's video. The next time we come back, we will be covering Operation Whiteout, which is the next stage of this campaign. Anyway, until then, take care. This is it for today. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, thank you for sticking around until the end. Until next time, farewell, fellow things.